Video 2.4 openHAB 3.0 UI Overview. In this video, we will cover the following topics: main UI, semantic modeling, pages, basic UI, HAB panel, which UI to choose. Now we have come to the user end of openHAB, which deals with the different user interfaces for various purposes. As shown here, openHAB 3.0 supports three UIs: the main UI, basic UI, and the HAB panel. A general criticism of openHAB 2 was the lack of functionality and flexibility of user interfaces like the paper UI and the classic UI. However, with the release of openHAB 3.0, the developers have introduced the new main UI that deprecates existing redundant user interfaces and acts as a single gateway to all openHAB functions and components. Though it involves new concepts such as pages and models, the main UI remains faithful to the traditional openHAB structure of defining things and items. Now let's take a look at the design goals of the main UI. 1. It is built for end users and administrators. For example, your grandparents as end users might find it user-friendly, while you also have lots of options to customize the UI. 2. The functionality overlap is reduced, although specialized UIs exist, such as the HAB panel and basic UI. 3. It is designed to work flawlessly on all screens, ranging from phones and tablets to desktops. 4. The main UI adapts to the design language of the current device it is running on. You can find this option in the Help and About section. Here, it switches to the Android, iOS, or PC versions according to the device. To better understand the main UI, let's understand the underlying concepts of semantic modeling and pages. A semantic model is a method to organize your items in openHAB by defining a logical structure for your smart home. Semantic models are used to automatically create different kinds of pages that contribute to the main UI. Besides this, semantic modeling also helps you define, generalize, and simplify rules based on patterns and common automation purposes. There are four main concepts in semantic modeling: location, equipment, point, and property. A location may consist of sublocations, equipment, or points, and they represent a physical location in your houses, for example, floors and rooms. Equipment is a group of items consisting of sub-equipments and points. A point represents individual items, and finally, a property is an additional tag for a point that describes it. As seen here in the main UI, there are four tabs at the bottom. The default tab is the overview page that can be customized entirely from scratch, and there are three other tabs for locations, equipments, and properties from the semantic model you have created. These tabs are empty now as a semantic model is not defined at present. But once such a model is defined, expandable cards will appear that reveal more information when clicked on it. Now let's look at the different pages that openHAB 3.0 offers. Layout pages are the most common and flexible way of displaying information. Users have extensive options to customize layout pages, and they also support widgets that are built-in and user-designed widgets. Maps and floor plans pages can display geographical information with markers on a background overlay. The overlays for floor plans can be custom images imported by the user, while maps provide zoom-in and zoom-out options for an actual map layer or satellite view images. Chart pages are implemented for interactive visualization of data that has been stored using persistence methods. Graphical information such as time series data, heat maps, and calendars can be displayed. If you wish to combine different pages that you have created to be displayed on a single page, the tabbed pages feature can be used. As explained earlier, you can access the basic UI and HAB panel by clicking on this icon. The basic UI is essentially a web interface based on Google's Material Design Lite framework. To use basic UI, you will have to create sitemaps from the configuration files, and each sitemap element has a specific syntax that has to be followed. Sitemaps have existed in openHAB from the beginning and are primarily used for basic UI and openHAB's mobile applications. Sitemaps have fewer options for customization when compared to pages, and it is to be noted that the main UI does not display sitemaps as of now. That is, you can only configure them via configuration files. Let us move on to the next user interface, HAB panel. HAB panel is mainly designed for touch-based dashboards, especially for wall-mounted tablets common in smart homes. It is installed by default and can be configured easily in the UI itself, without configuration files. Unlike Basic UI, HABPanel does not require sitemaps and can be set up once items are defined. HABPanel has its entities or building blocks as shown here. The panel registry is the central storage for a particular openHAB instance. It consists of several panel configurations representing different devices running HABPanel, such as the wall tablet and another tablet for the administrator. Panels are a set of dashboards or pages that are presented to the users. HABPanel interacts with the end user in the form of different widgets that are contained within dashboards. Now, a common beginner question would be, where do I start with the UI? Or how to choose the best UI for my smart home? Well, the recommended way to get started with your openHAB interface is by modeling your smart home using a semantic model in the main UI. Once you have done this, you can use the main UI to manage your things and items. As explained earlier, there are two ways of going about this: the file-based and the UI-driven approach. You can always use the main UI to keep track of your items and groups irrespective of the configuration method you choose. Then you can branch out to the application-specific UIs like the Basic UI and HABPanel for further customization of your smart home system. Also, please check out the resources of this video for a video demo of the main UI features from openHAB Virtual Meet 2020. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: main UI, semantic modeling, pages, Basic UI, HABPanel, which UI to choose. In the next video, we will have an in-depth overview of the main UI dashboard.